A map entirely designed by us players. This idea was recently announced by DICE, which I'm sure you may know all about. If you haven't, it's basically a slight look into content for BF4 this year. And to start it off, we have an awesome opportunity to build a map together, which is probably the closest thing we're ever going to see to mod support in a modern day Battlefield game. I mean, the layout, theme, and overall design of the map will be from us players, but DICE will make it instead of modding devs like how it used to be in the old days. But let's talk details. The way it's going to work is DICE want to just get the project rolling, so I imagine proper ways of communication to the playbase, which it looks like they have done. You can leave your feedback on the official CTA Reddit page, like you can see here. I'll leave a link in the description, or you can join the community map forum thread on the official CTA forums. Once again, I'll leave a link in the description. However, we do have some basic guidelines and whatnot before you can even think about leaving feedback. I suggest to try and read the proper documentation first, which I'll also leave a link in the description. But basically, they want a core Battlefield experience, which is vehicle friendly, though I don't think they want vehicles to dominate. It seems like we're going for a more infantry focused map with various transport vehicles, maybe a scout heli as well. The main game mode will be Conquest, and one thing I like about this page here, it says maximize gameplay destruction, which is really cool to hear. Currently we're into the concept phase, so that means just putting together a rough idea of locations, themes, and layout of the map. But like I said, I'll leave a link in the description so you guys can read it all for yourself. Also, if you want to leave feedback, try and be as clear and detailed as possible. Maybe create some basic MS Paint mockups with some pictures of real life locations. I'm sure DICE would appreciate that. Also, if you're wondering about, do we need to pay for this map once it comes out? The answer is no. It will be free for all players on all platforms. So as for a map idea, I had a good think about this last night, and for me, I would love to see a really full on jungle type setting. That includes a very dense plant life and trees that I hope can be destroyed either by bullets spraying all over the place or from explosives or even catching fire. I don't know if that's kind of pushing hardware restrictions on the last gen consoles. I'm thinking the map can't be too wide, but at the same time, not that linear. We can have one jet attack heli and scout heli for each of the sides, but also giving infantry a slight upper hand because of the dense nature of the map that provides a lot of cover from the air. But at the same time, it's going to create a lot of tense gameplay and gunfights. Of course, there's going to be pathways that isn't covered by any kind of trees or plant life leading towards each of the capture points. And speaking of the capture points, I think making a few of them an area that opens up and maybe have a few that are still somewhat in the dense jungle, I think that would work out nicely. I might do a mock-up of the map layout and other details, but at the moment, that's just my first idea for a map design. Anyway, back to future content for BF4. You may have noticed in the official article on Battlelog, it says expect game updates and tweaks and things like a weapon pack, but also one or two bigger content drops. First of all, it says weapon pack, so I'm pretty sure it's safe to say we're going to see more weapons in the game at some point in the future. I'm really hoping it's fan favorite weapons from the past BF titles, and not just some random weapons. I know some people say there's already too many in the game, but honestly, I wouldn't mind a few fan favorite weapons for each of the classes. Like for example, the assault class can get the AN-94, or maybe we can get the AKS-74U carbine, like how we had in previous Battlefield games. That would be an awesome addition into BF4. Also, the last part of the sentence, it says one or two bigger content drops. I don't know if this will be in the form of a DLC or just a general patch that includes content, but I can imagine we might see this community built map bundled with maybe a few night maps like we've already seen Infiltration of Shanghai on CTA. And maybe the second content drop will contain remastered versions of previous maps from older Battlefield games, which sounds like that still will be the case. David did say the whole community design map project doesn't mean we won't see maps from older BF games in BF4. He also said we will revisit the map survey we had a while ago, and the results of it will come out in due time. And you may have heard about the winter patch arriving in March. By the way, March is going to be a pretty busy time. Like I said, we have the winter patch, we have Hardline coming out, and for PC players like myself, we have GTA 5 coming out, so it's going to be a crazy month. I'm going to have to work out some way of uploading a video each day. But going back to the winter patch itself, it will contain improvements to netcode and soldier collision, which means no more getting stuck on stupid objects like a small rock or a slight step. Also, it will bring in tweaks to squad obliteration competitive game mode, which I hope works out because it sounds like it will heavily be focused on teamwork and will be the lead competitive game mode for BF4. Also, the winter patch will not contain any Estron nerfs and unfortunately will not contain the hit marker and sight reticle color and size customization feature, which is what I'm really looking forward to, so I'm a little bit disappointed about that. I guess we're just going to have to wait a little longer. Also, just a quick note, we once again are allowed to disable the HUD on the CTE client, which is great news for taking screenshots and capturing footage for cinematic videos. For me, it's always been a slight issue trying to get a nice screenshot for a thumbnail, so I'm glad we have that feature again. And just before I finish the video, I want to let you guys know I changed my CTE server to run Infiltration of Shanghai. If you're in the Oceanic region and want to try the nighttime map for yourself on a low latency, it does say unknown for the map name, but don't worry too much about that. It's only on PC CTE, so I'll leave a link in the description if you wish to try it out for yourself. But anyway, thanks for watching, and make sure to leave feedback on the CTA Reddit page if you want to bring forward your ideas. Just make sure to be as clear and detailed as possible. So, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.